Hello, how are you? My name is Pádraig Jack. I'm a bilingual singer-songwriter from the Aran Islands here, and I'm currently standing on Inishmore, which is the largest of the three Aran Islands. The islands are situated in Galway Bay off the west coast of Ireland, and I was born and raised on this island here in Inishmore, and I'm going to sing you a few songs for this St. Patrick's Day weekend, which I hope you're enjoying, despite the fact there are no parades on this year in most places, if not all over the world. Hopefully we'll still make the most of it. So this island is about 850 people living here. As I mentioned, I was born and raised here. My dad is from here. My mother's from Connemara there, not too far away. So I would have spoke both English and Irish growing up. As much English really, because my mother wasn't a fluent speaker when she moved here. But if you live on the island, we go to school through Irish, and you kind of, you live through both languages. So, and I also write and sing songs in both languages. So I'm going to sing you the title track of my current album, which is called Making Sand. It's actually a bilingual song as well. It's a song I wrote about the island, about the culture and the people on the island, but also I was trying to capture a sense of the fact that this is, you know, a rock sticking out of the water out in the Atlantic. And I think I was just trying to capture a sense of the what it is, of what the Aran Islands are. So it's a song called Making Sand, and I hope you enjoy it. Islands stand amongst the waves out here, from Inishmore and Inishmeon to Inisir. The ocean lives amongst us, grinding rocks around us. We're just making sand out here. Prehistoric forts were laid out here, and monks and scholars welcomed saints and peers. From cliffs where forts are standing, some rocks below are landing, just making sand out here. And the roads they cease at Rosseville, long ago they rode their carrocks here, with bones of burren marrow, shared blood with Connemara. We're just making sand out here. The seaside yields a fertile sod out here, and fishermen have another god to fear. The sea, it gives a plenty, but it can take so quickly, just making sand out here. An ancient language is ingrained out here. Edan Chir Le Changa Anamachosin Chijanta, just making sand out here. And the roads they cease at Rosseville, long ago they rode their carrocks here, with bones of barren marrow, shared blood with Connemara. We're just making sand out here. Kel chochen yachomu ik chachten sha shan khidan kolis klu toy gun sha elan all in ach jakos marajero jeron so flarto so de jon ganye the mon sha. And the roads they cease at Rosseville, long ago they rode their carrocks here, with bones of barren marrow, shared blood with Connemara. We're just making sand out here. And the roads they cease at Rosseville. Long ago they rode their caroffs here with bones of barren marrow. Shared blood with Connemara, we're just making sand out here. Three Chelchach and Yachamu, a chacht and shaw, Shanachuidon a call is clue, a toy goon shaw, Ilan all in Ach Jacket. Marajed O'Geron, so flartos, Yadig John O'Ganye, Amon Shom. And the roads they cease at Rosseville. Long ago they rode their carrocks here with bones of barren marrow. Shared blood with Connemara, we're just making sand out here. And the roads they cease at Rosseville. Long ago they rode their carrocks here with bones of barren marrow. Shared blood with Connemara, we're just making sand out here. We're just making sand out here. So that was Making Sand, which is the title track of my debut album, my current album. So I'd planned to release that album around this time last year, and it was actually around the first. There was a single coming out 3 days before St. Patrick's Day last year in March, and obviously that was the time the pandemic was hitting. So obviously it's affected the whole world in so many different ways. But for me, with my music, I think the release of the album had to be postponed, and I had album launches, and I work with a label in London, and I recorded the album in London also, and I had album launches in Galway, Dublin and London, and also I had tours booked for last summer in France and Germany, which obviously have been postponed. So maybe next year, hopefully, at this point, maybe later this year, that could even happen. So that was Making Sand. So I'm going to sing another song now off the same album. Another song I wrote. I released this song as a single, actually. It was the first single release off that album. And it's a song called Mini. It's a song I wrote a few years ago, again, in the winter on the island here. And I released it as a single over a year ago now. And I'm going to sing this for you now, and I hope you enjoy it. Minnie ever lived her life out loud with her sunshades on, ever singing a song. Minnie married to a middle-aged man, didn't marry for love. She was happy enough, she said, "Yoo-hoo, am I doing it right?" I said, "Minnie, yoo-hoo, gotta set things right." Minnie drives with a bright smile on, lets her curls hang down, they speak volumes of fun. But honest eyes complied in a lie, she was incomplete, she was starting to die. And she said, "Uh-oh, am I doing it right?" I said, "Minnie, you, I've got to set things right." And as we drank some wine and watched the sun go down in the back room, Minnie Many said what she had to say. Now her husband's gone, he didn't touch her anyway. Single mom reignites her spark. Minnie's holding strong. Her noose is gone and she said, ooh, ooh, I can feel it again. A new woman, she said, need not pretend anymore. And like wide-eyed teens, we set our spirits free. At the windowsill, against her soft back skin, and I wanted to tell her more, but I never did. And I wanted to give her more, but I never did. And I wanted to love her more. Five-year gap, so's fears. Minnie scared me off, it was a step too far. I couldn't see what we had been, just a fling-run thing, but I had set the scene. I said, I can't commit to this. She said, after tonight, we can just be friends. And as the Galway sky, let the sun pass by in silence. We drank our last red wine and watched the sun go down and said goodbye. And Minnie's happy now, she found love somehow. So that's a song called Minnie off my aforementioned debut album. So I'm here, as I said, on the Aran Islands on Inishmore, and I'm currently standing on a 3,000-year-old stone fort. So we're going to take a break, and we'll be back to you in a few minutes, and hope to see you then. Hi guys, Pádraig Jack here again. Welcome back. I hope you're enjoying your St. Patrick's Day weekend. So I'm here still on Inishmore, but I've moved to a different part of the island. So I'm towards the back of the island, and as you can see, the 300-foot cliffs behind me in the distance. And the sun has come out somewhat, which is not so common this time of year around these parts. And the wild Atlantic Way, the sea is raging a little bit as well. Again, it's a relatively calm day. So I'm going to continue my show here. I'm going to sing a song next. This song is one of my favourite songs to sing. It was originally a poem written by the Irish poet Patrick Kavanagh, and I believe he gave it to the singer Luke Kelly from the Dubliners, who was a friend of his, and he put it to music. So it's one of Ireland's best known songs, and in fact I believe it was voted Ireland's favourite folk song, and it's my favourite song to sing. And incidentally, a couple of years ago, I was singing it in my parents' pub on the island here, and to a group of Americans, I believe. And after the performance, a gentleman came up to me, and congratulated me. He really enjoyed my version of the song, and turned out he was Jimmy Kelly, who was Luke Kelly of the Dubliners' brother. Poor Jimmy himself actually passed away a couple of years ago. He used to visit the island regularly. But that was a really nice moment for me, you know, knowing that he appreciated my version of it. But I'm going to sing that song for you now. So I hope you enjoy it. It's a song called Raglan Road, as known by the Dubliners, and I hope you enjoy it. On Raglan Road, on an autumn day, I saw her first and knew that her dark hair would weave a snare that I might one day rue. I saw the danger as I passed along the enchanted way, and I said, let grief be a falling leaf at the dawning of the day. On Grafton Street in November we trip lightly along the ledge of a deep ravine where can be seen the worst of passion's pledge. The queen of hearts still baking tarts, and I not making hay. Well, I love too much, and such by such is happiness thrown away. I gave her gifts of the mind, I gave her the secret signs that known to the artists who have known the true gods of sound and stone. With word and tint I did not stand. I gave her poems to say. With her own name there and her own dark hair like clouds over fields of on a quiet street where old ghosts meet, I see her walking now. Away from me so hurriedly, my reason must allow. For I have loved not as I should, a creature made of clay. When the angel looms, the clay illumes his wings at the dawn of day. So, I was saying thank you. I've forgotten what it's like to play in front of an audience, I think, after the lockdown for the last year or so. So that was Raglan Road. That's, I think, one of my favourite songs to sing. It's a well-known Irish folk song, and I think it's sung at every sing-song in a house or a pub or wherever around Ireland and outside of Ireland, I'm sure, and plenty outside of Ireland as well, I'm sure. So that's Raglan Road. So as I said, I'm here at the back of Inishmore on the Aran Islands, my home, where I'm from. I'm not literally here. I'm from this island. I hope you're enjoying the music so far and having a nice St. Patrick's Day and enjoying the rest of all of the events that are happening in the St. Patrick's Day Festival streaming that's happening over these few days. So I hope you're enjoying it all. And as I said, it's an honor for me to be even involved in this and to be taking part and as part of the festival and to welcome you all to Inishmore. So moving on, I'm going to sing my final song now. I played earlier a couple of songs off my first album, songs that I'd released, that I'd written. And this next song is one that I've written in Irish, but it's actually a song that I translated. So I didn't write the original version in English, but I translated it into Irish. And it's an old song that I originally had heard it growing up on the island. My dad had sung it. It's a song originally called One Starry Night, was the original version. And I thought my dad had written it because he's a prolific and brilliant songwriter himself. And he used to sing it, and I thought he had written this song. But when I asked him, he said no. He thought a singer called Sean Tyrrell, who's from County Galway, had written it. So after I translated it to Irish, I contacted Sean Tyrrell just to let him know that I'd written this Irish version. And he said, geez, thanks for letting me know, he said. But he said, do you know what, I didn't write that. He said he's known for singing it, but he said he had heard it from a singer from Dublin named Liam Weldon, who was a singer and song collector who would have released the song in the 60s or 70s. And he said, I heard it from him, but he said, I don't think he wrote it either. He said he thinks it's an old gypsy folk song that he had collected, and he doesn't know who had written it. And it's a really old Irish song. But it's a lovely song and a lovely melody, and it tells a story of a long lost love. And like, I'm going to sing it in Irish now, but just to explain what it's about, it's a song about someone who wakes up and their love is gone, and they roam through the boreens and the villages searching for her, and you know, he doesn't find her. And like any true good Irish folk song, it gets fairly sad after that, and turn, you know, there's talk of alcohol and stuff and themes of death and things like that in the song. But it's a lovely melody and a lovely song and a lovely story. As I said, I had heard it growing up from my dad singing it, and we're a very musical family. And I think I just love the melody and I love the story. So I decided, as we do speak Irish out here, and we're in a region of Ireland that is, it's an ever decreasing region that's called the Gaeltacht. It's the region where the Irish language is still the predominant language spoken. So I think it's nice, it's a nice thing to do, and I just felt like this song really worked in the Irish language. So I'm going to sing this song for you now. It's a song called Ihigal, which literally means moonlit night, even though the original English version was One Starry Night. But I think that's how we'd say it in Irish, or at least how I would anyway.
Agus thraish me hulsha vitu emi wen yul men the boy Ar fud na bailte Thuart a me na rogini Na loistín is brú Tuar a me fui aistair Ar muintir na hoche Eich fys rú focal No fire food is lore in the meal chair. Hash the moist kajisha. Is minica be a merchant? Hawk ham. Feast keen Mujlekele huihe, achenishakem vitu erkis. Tan jochlom nyo ni fene kevian skana Rui gire jia wal Fo seng thol amu Nor a veis me bossi Smoskel so kriachli Mali bon stori Taras karmeshi Eri hegam Himalai salabo Eri hegam Imring lodge fear Kholas rochi kar Gimoth wen sanihe Achenish tatu imi ahra Tiach maagam vebos Achenish tatu imi ahra Tiach maagam vebos
I hope you've enjoyed your visit to the Aran Islands and enjoyed the music. And I hope you have a great St. Patrick's Day. And if we happen to meet in Ireland or in Aran or in any other part of the world at any point in the future, that would be great. And so I hope you have a great St. Patrick's Day. And thanks very much. My name is Pádraig Jack. Slán go fóill agus tuaradh.